episode 3122, A Sacrifice of Praise.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day. I hope you are having a pleasurable weekend with your family, getting some rest and rejuvenation for your heart. Today is all about reflection, your time, spending it with God, and what He has in store for you, a sacrifice of praise. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. All right, I want to start off real quick. If you want to get in touch with me, you've got some ideas because I've got an announcement coming up, but I'll give it to you here in a minute. Drop me an email at connect@createyournow.com. Okay, connect@createyournow.com. It comes right to me. You can send me suggestions, what you want to hear, what you want to see. I mean, maybe you want me to do a simulcast. I mean, we're already in TV. We've got some things coming up. Let me tell you, God is moving and there's some incredible things happening. So with that being said, today is my last day, only for a week. I just had to put that out there. I'm coming back. I promise I'm coming back. But I need some time. I need some time with my family. I need some time with God. I need to be able to discern what God is doing here at Create Your Now. I named Create Your Now, right? I mean, technically I did. But it wasn't just me who named. It was God who gave it to me, but also through my children. My family is wrapped up in this as much as I am. And you are too, because you're my family. And so when I look at all of what we do, right, create your now. It's not create my now. It's not about me. This is not about me. This is all about you. And so I really want to be able to serve you. So if you're like, gosh, I really wish Christiane would do this, or would you speak about this? Send me an email. It comes directly to me. Now, I've got a lot going on next week, so I can't promise I'll answer immediately, but I will do my best to respond in a reasonable fashion, okay? Because it's not a team member doing this, the team of like three, which is all my family. But when I do, it will be me sitting behind the keyboard. And so I just want to give that to you. And if you're wondering, what do I do while you're gone? There's plenty of stuff. If you haven't seen our TV show, go check it out. You can go over to pray.com and check it out there. It's video on demand. So you can just type in either Create Your Now when you get to it, or just type in Christiane Wargo, whatever you want to do. It'll pop up, go down, slide down, and you'll see it at the bottom, the videos, and you can click on whichever. I think we got like 30 of them. So you can't be bored. And we have over, oh, I don't know, we're getting close to 3,200 episodes. It is ridiculous. So you got plenty to listen to while I'm gone. I will miss you, but I will be back. So I want to send you off with this Bible verse. It comes from Hebrews chapter 13, verse 15. Through Jesus, therefore, let us continually offer to God a sacrifice of praise, the fruit of lips that openly profess His name. My friend, when was the last time you praised God's name? When did you praise Him? Because I'm sure you have asked for more from Him than giving Him the praises He deserves. Right? If you're a praying person, you're probably like, Lord, come on. Would you just show up here for me? Would you just do this for me? And if you do, then I'll be here more often. I'll read, you know, a chapter every single day. You know those moments. But I really want you to think about this for a minute. We need to give God a sacrifice of praise continually. And I want to remind you of that today because of the power and importance of offering that gratitude, the adoration, the praise to our Heavenly Father. It's easy to get swallowed up by everything that's going on in the world, and you lose sight of who's in control. And in a world where you often seek to be present with your needs and requests before God, right? You want to say, here, Lord, this is what I need. I give them to you. I'm laying them at your feet, which is great. That's what He wants us to do. But He also needs to know that we love Him and that we respect Him and we want to listen to Him. So it's crucial that you also understand the significance of praising him for who he is and what he has done for you, for me. A sacrifice of praise. You know, our journey as Christians is centered around sacrifice. Jesus Christ himself was the ultimate sacrifice for you, for your sins, offering his life to bring salvation to the world. That's your eternal gift. And in light of his sacrificial love, you are called to mirror the sacrificial nature in your life. So what better way to do so than by offering a sacrifice of praise? And I also, you know, in looking at this, God has given you a beautiful gift, the gift of speech. I mean, look at us right now. I get to talk to you, and you could be over in a totally different country, and you can hear this. And if you don't get to listen to all of it at one time, you get to replay it. Our words possess incredible power, capable of both building up and tearing down. So when we offer praise, we channel this like immense power toward honoring our Heavenly Father. We're lifting him up with our words, with our breath. He deserves that. So let your lips be the vessel through which gratitude and worship and praise and adoration flow nonstop. The grocery store, while you're taking the kids to activities, school's going to be starting up. Oh my goodness, are you ready for it? You may need to be praying in the pickup line. I'm just saying. Bring glory to his name. Our purpose in life is to glorify him, to know him. You know, we live in a world desperately, desperately seeking hope, searching for something to believe in. You found someone who you know. It's your faith of Christianity. It's your faith and belief in Jesus Christ. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. And in such a time, you are called to boldly profess the name of Jesus Christ, the source of all hope for the world to see. I know you need to see it. I need to see that hope. I need to be reminded of it. You can be living a pretty good world, but you know, things still happen. You get cracks in your windshield. You get poopy dumps in the morning from your aging dog. You need to know that, okay, God's even got the poop. I'm just saying. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. My friend, he's got you in his hands. But are you lifting him up? Are you willing to lift him up in a manner that's a sacrifice of praise? Your life should reflect the glorious truth of the gospel, that Jesus Christ has risen from the dead. He is alive. He is within you. Why? Through the Holy Spirit. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Drawing others closer to him through our words and actions. We've got to continually offer God our praises. So don't limit your praise to specific moments or occasions alone. Don't just say, oh Lord, thank you so much for, you know, for just healing me and taking care of this. Yeah, that's important. Healing is fabulous. But what about, Lord, thank you for getting me to, you know, pick up the kids safely. Thank you that my car is still running. Thank you, Lord, that I have money in the bank that I can go buy groceries this week. Lord, thank you for the time that I get to spend with my family. Lord, thank you for showing up when I don't want to. May your life be a constant symphony of praise and worship, marked by hearts that overflow with thanksgiving and devotion, right? You want your heart just to overflow with it in every season, through every trial and every blessing. Let your praises rise to the heavens. So as we pause for just a moment, reflecting on Hebrews chapter 13, verse 15, let us respond to God's call, surrendering our hearts to him and offering a sacrifice of praise in return for his abundant grace, love, and mercy. God's got you, my friend. Let him hold you. Let him love you. At the same time, though, let him know that you love him. So let us rejoice, for our Savior lives. May the fruit of our lips openly profess his name. as we continue to offer a sacrifice of praise. I'll see you in a week. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed week. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.